welcome to Byte Size Med. This video is a compilation of a bunch of recall cards that I've created on bone histology. I've put together 10 quizzes and each is around a minute long. If you'd like to do them at random, you can check out my playlist linked in the description box below. But for this video, press pause when I tell you to and try and recall as much as you can. We'll start with the structure of a long bone. Your task is to recall what are the three parts of a long bone. What are the layers of bone from outside in? Bones have marrow. Where is that marrow located? And what are the two types? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need for recall. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Long bones have three parts. The shaft is called the diaphysis, the ends are called the epiphyses, and the expanded ends of the diaphysis form the metaphyses. In general, from the outside in, bone has a periosteum, compact bone, cancellous bone, and a central medullary cavity. But the layers would depend on the level. For example, the epiphysis has a lot of cancellous bone and no medullary cavity, while in the diaphysis, most of the cancellous bone gets replaced by the medullary cavity. Bone marrow is located in spaces formed by trabeculae of cancellous bone and in the medullary cavity. Adult long bones usually have yellow marrow in the shaft, which is fat, though some long bones can have red marrow in the epiphyses, which can synthesize blood cells. Bone is tissue, and tissue has cells, bone cells, like the osteoblast. Your task is to recall how many nuclei this cell has, what's its function, which layer of bone is it located in, and it has a receptor for an important hormone that regulates calcium. Name that hormone. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to recall what you know about this cell. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The osteoblast just has a single nucleus, unlike the osteoclast. Its main function is the synthesis of proteins for the bone matrix. It's located in the periosteum and the endosteum layers of bone, and it has a receptor for the parathyroid hormone, which is an important calcium-regulating hormone. That's an important bone cell. These bones form the skeleton, and there are different types of bones. You've got to match an example with the type of bone. For today's match, we've got a vertebra, the scaphoid, the pisiform, and the metacarpal. Match each with the type of bone, long, irregular, short, or sesamoid. Once you identify the sesamoid bone, a little extra question here. Which tendon is that bone located in? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to match them up. I only get 1 minute, so time's up. The vertebra is an irregular bone. That one's easy. The scaphoid is a short bone, as are all the carpal bones. The pisiform, which is a carpal bone, is a sesamoid bone. And the metacarpal, though it looks short, it's a long bone because the length is more than the breadth. Lastly, the pisiform bone is in the tendon of flexor carpi ulnaris. Bone has more than just one kind of cell. Our next one is the osteoclast. Your task is to recall how many nuclei the cell has, what's its function, what layer of bone is it located in, and it has a receptor for a hormone that can regulate calcium. Name that hormone. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to recall what you know about this cell. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The osteoclast is a multinucleated giant cell, a physiological giant cell. It digests bone. Its function, thus, is bone resorption. It's located along with the osteoblasts and osteoprogenitor cells in the periosteum and the endosteum layers of bone. It has a receptor for calcitonin, which keeps calcium in bones. It's tempting to say PTH, but PTH receptors are on the osteoblasts, not the osteoclasts. Now we'll bring back some of those different types of bones again. You've got to match an example with the type of bone it belongs to. For examples, we've got the rib, the clavicle, atlas, and the medial cuneiform. Are these bones flat, irregular, short, or long bones? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. Your task is to match the bone to its type. I only get 1 minute, so time's up. The ribs are flat bones. They protect organs in the thoracic cage. The clavicle is a long bone. Atlas, which is the first cervical vertebra, is an irregular bone. And the medial cuneiform, which is a small bone in the foot, along with the other tarsal bones, is a short bone. Bone has got quite a few cells, but for this one, let's try something different. I'll describe the cell. Your task is to recall what the name of this cell is. It's got cytoplasmic processes and is located in lacunae in the bone matrix. Once you figure out which cell I'm talking about, which cell is this cell derived from, and how do these cells communicate? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. What cell am I talking about? But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. The osteocytes are located in lacunae, which are spaces between the layers of the bone matrix. They have cytoplasmic processes that sit in canaliculi. These are trapped osteoblasts. Osteoblasts are the ones that synthesize the bone matrix, and as they do so, some get trapped and form osteocytes. The osteocytes communicate with each other and osteoblasts using gap junctions. Osteoblasts, osteoclasts, and osteocytes. Those are three important bone cells. Bone undergoes remodeling. Now, which of these cells is needed for that process to happen? The osteoblasts, the osteoclasts, or the osteoprogenitor cells. You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. Which cell is needed for bone remodeling? But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. I should have given you a fourth option, all of them. Bone remodeling needs them all. Osteoclasts resorb bone. Osteoprogenitor cells can differentiate into osteoblasts, which can then synthesize bone matrix. That then gets mineralized. Bone remodeling happens throughout life in response to different stresses and strains that the bone faces. And it needs all of these cells. Bone remodeling happens throughout life, but let's go back to their origins now. Bone formation. Your task is to recall what that process is called. What are the two ways that can happen? Which one of these involves cartilage? And I'll give you two examples of bones, the parietal bone and the humerus. They form by which of these two processes? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. Bones form by a process called ossification. That can happen directly from the mesenchyme when it's called intramembranous ossification, or from a cartilaginous template when it's called endochondral ossification. Here, cartilage gets replaced by bone. It doesn't form bone, it gets replaced. Parietal bone, which is a flat bone of the skull vault, is a membrane bone forming by intramembranous ossification. And the humerus, which is a long bone, is a cartilage bone forming by endochondral ossification. That's bone formation. Bones form and they grow. Bones grow because of this cartilaginous structure. Your task is to recall what it's called. What type of cartilage does it have? Is it temporary or permanent? And in a long bone like this, where else would you find cartilage that stays permanently? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. This structure between the epiphysis and the diaphysis of a growing bone is the epiphyseal plate of cartilage, or the epiphyseal growth plate. It is hyaline cartilage and it is temporary. Once bone reaches its final length, the bone fuses and there is an epiphyseal line. Bone replaces the cartilage. But at the ends of the long bone is another hyaline cartilage called articular cartilage. Now that is permanent. Our last one is on the structure of bone again. When you look at a cross-section of bone, you see structures that sort of look like this. Your task is to identify the structure. What's it called? What is this structure in the center? What are these layers? And what are these cells? You can pause the video here and take as much time as you need to figure it out. But I just get 1 minute, so time's up. This is an osteon. Multiple osteons make up the structure of bone. It's also called a Haversian system. And each osteon has a central canal called a Haversian canal. This has blood vessels and nerves, and it's surrounded by concentric layers of bone matrix. That's layers and layers of calcified bone matrix with trapped osteocytes in between the layers. That's the cell, the osteocyte. That's all I've got for now, but a quick tip for if you make notes in histology is to use colors and draw small doodles to represent the cells. Their names can look similar sometimes, so quick doodles like these can help you remember the cell and sometimes can help with remembering some of its structural features. I hope these recall cards were helpful. Leave me a comment if you do like them and if you'd want more on other topics that I've made videos on. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.